Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube. Are you an end user of Power BI? Someone just consuming content? You're just looking at the report. In this video, I'm going to walk you through and show you how to use an actual report in Power BI to get the most out of your experience. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, reports. You are maybe new to Power BI, or you've been using it a little bit and you're not sure like everything that's available for you inside of an actual report inside of Power BI. I did a video not too long ago looking at the actual Power BI experience all up for consumers or end users. So this was just more exploring the portal, the different options that were available. This video is more focused on the report itself. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and see what this is all about. So we're looking at Power BI, and there are a couple different ways that we can get to the report. First off, you may have been sent just an email with a direct link or something that said, click here to view report. There are other ways that you could get to it as well. One thing you can see is I've got a featured item here. We've got favorites and frequents as well. You can get to favorites over on the right. All of that I talked about in the other video. So go check that out if you want to know more. I'm going to make an assumption here that we're going to be consuming the report from a app perspective. I'm also not going to get into any of the licensing items. There is stuff that applies there, so just be aware of that. But we're going to assume that we're going to go through the app itself. I'm going to go ahead and hit on apps, and then I'm going to select my AdventureWorks sales, which is the app that I'm interested in. When this comes up, we can actually see the report. We've got some values and stuff. I can get a feel for what it is the data is that I'm looking at. One thing to note here is that there are a couple areas in this report that we need to pay attention to. First off, the filter pane over on the far right here. We can show and hide that. This may actually not be available for you. So if you don't see it, don't freak out. The report author may have just said hide this by default, and that's okay. But this is where you can kind of, you know, look at filters, apply other filters potentially, and just interact further with that report. We can filter that data down. Right now we can see the country is set to United States. Another thing to know in terms of filtering or slicing and dicing, you may have heard that before, is that visuals are interactive. That's one of the great things about Power BI. So I can say, click on Texas, the great state of Texas, and it's going to automatically apply the filter to the other visuals. I can unselect it, and that will hold true as well. One thing I can also do that you may not be aware of is, let's say I select Texas again, and I've filtered the data. If I hold control down, and then let's say I'm going to click on black, I'm going to further filter the data down. So it's kind of a combo filter there between visuals. And then I can just click over on Texas again, reset all of it, and we're back to the way we were. Let's talk about tooltips. When you hover over data, you may get additional information, right? So we can see given sales information for Texas, that when I hover over Texas itself, there's also this concept of report level tooltips where you may get additional customized data. So let's look at this line chart in the upper right. And when I hover over an item, we can see additional data. Oh, look at that. This is amazing sales. That's what we want to see. And sometimes it'll go negative, and that's just not a good time. And that's okay too. So, but you can see that there's a way that you may have a customized tooltip experience. So hover over data, explore some of the data that's in there to see what other information you may gain about your report. There are maybe buttons or just images on a given report that you can interact with as well. You can see some items over here where I've got this little filter kind of icon, and then I've got this question mark. So I talked before about like hovering over items. One trick that I really love that you may see in your report is this ability to give additional information. So you may see something there, and if I just click on that, it's actually going to tell me what this report is all about. This may or may not be available to you though, because of the fact that the report author has to implement that. So if it's not implemented in the report, you may not see it. But if you can give that feedback and let the report author know that that's something that you want to see in the report, that would just make it helpful to understand what's going on in the report and what this data is all about. So it's always a good thing to have. And then I can just click somewhere and get out of it. All right, if I select on a given visual here, we'll see like this visual level toolbar. So sometimes it's hard. This one's easier to see. If I hover over the tooltip or this filter icon for the visual, I can see additional filter context, right? There we go. Filters also in slicers that are affecting the visual. That's that's just going to be what we've done from a filter pane perspective, as well as what may be doing from other slicers. And we'll come back to slicers, but that's a way that you can get some more information about what's filtering down that visual. Another item you may want to see, so let's look at this line chart, is we can actually do focus mode, which will actually just bring it up and kind of explode it a little bit, so you can get a bigger view of what that data actually is. Another thing to be aware of here is that you'll see some like drill type items here. Not all visuals are going to have this, so it depends on the visual itself, but in this case I can like go up a level, you can explore things, I could go down a level, or I could say, hey, expand everything. And depending on the visual, that may do different things. So in this case, it showed the years and the months. If you're in a like table or matrix, it may expand that out further. Again, play around with these items and see what's going on. In the ellipsis of a visual, you're going to see different items as well. We can comment, we can chat in Teams. We'll come back to that. We can also export data. So if I click on that, we could actually choose to export from XLS or CSV. These options may be different depending on how the report or the data is configured. So just be aware of that. Same thing with being able to summarize data or get the underlying data. It depends how it's configured. The one thing I would challenge you though, play around with Power BI a little bit more and see what you can do to explore that data, because you may be surprised of what you can do by exploring that data. So don't just be immediate to say, let's go to Excel because we're comfortable with that. Give Power BI a chance. The other thing you can do in there, you can do sorting. So you can sort ascending, descending, change your sort by field on these items. So those are all available for you. Depending on the visual, those options may change. You can also do what's referred to as a spotlight, where it's just gonna really focus in on that. We'll come back to spotlight here in a second, because there's a very cool thing we can do there. I'm just gonna click here in the gray to get it out of that spotlight mode. This report doesn't have additional pages, but if it did, it would actually be expanded onto the default page. And you could click around on those items to see other pages that may be available in the report. There also may be like buttons or images in the report that allow for that exploration of items. One thing I know that folks have not been super aware of, let me go again, and we've got our great state of Texas. If I hover over that, you're going to see right click to drill through. So there's different options we can do that. I could just right click and do that drill through. I've also got something enabled in this visual where if I select a state, you'll see this click for state detail has lit up on me. So if I uncheck that, you'll see here it says click a state to enable drill through. Let's click again, and then it's going to take me to that drill through page for the given state information that I'm interested in. And then I can go back if I want to. I can get there the same way by doing the right click and drill through down to state detail. It does the same thing. So there's a lot of different ways to do something inside of Power BI. And then you'll see another button here in terms of the total sales by color. We could see this decomposition. So this is just another button option to take you to another exploration of a given report. So again, explore the report and see what's actually available to you. I mentioned slicers before too. There's a filter pane that we have in this report where it's gonna show you some items, and we can actually further slice and dice, similar to the filter pane that I showed earlier, but this item is actually using slicers in the report to further filter down the data. And so like right now I've got 2014 selected, and if we go back to the report and I hover over there, you're going to see that filter now, because the slicer is slicing by year. Now we see the year there as well as the country, so it's a combination of the filters and the slicers themselves. Let me go ahead and undo that. The other thing I want to call out is just this toolbar up top. So there's additional options that we can do inside of Power BI. So I can go to file, I can save a copy of the report, print it, I can export these items to PDF. Also, analyze in Excel is there as well. Remember I mentioned about exporting that data and going to Excel? Another option for you would be this analyze in Excel. So it's gonna connect Excel to that underlying data, assuming this is enabled for the given report, and allow you to actually explore it in a pivot table or chart with that actual data, the same data that's used for the report. So that's really great from a consistency perspective. You don't have to keep refreshing data and whatnot, just connect directly to it. Sharing may be enabled for this given report, so we can embed items, generate a QR code that may be, again, dependent on how it's configured. Another item I wanna call out, I talked about the spotlight before, so let me go back here. You may want to save a given state of a given visual. You can do that by way of bookmarks, which are up here. You can create a personal bookmark. There may be bookmarks that are already created for the given report, but what's really cool is in this spotlight, you may want to create a focus to tell a given story. What you can do here is we could actually set up the visual and then actually say, let's chat in teams and share this out with someone in my organization, right? And so that is an option for you that you can go through and share given states to allow people to get right to what it is you're trying to tell them or what's important for what you're trying to communicate. So that's a way that Power BI can integrate with other things and or share that experience with others to make storytelling with data just that much easier. One thing we can do if we have filters set or we don't have the original experience actually in the given reports, I can just click around, change state of a bunch of things. There is a button here to revert and reset back to the original view of the report. So we can always get back to the default state, click there and then hit reset and bam, we're back to the original report view of what was intended for this report. So when in doubt, hit that reset. You'll see it's grayed out right now. And then if you want to also, you can favorite this app, play around with some other things. There are high contrast colors available. So if you want, just look at the report in a different view, you can go ahead and do that as well. All right, hopefully this just gave you a good overview of a report and how to explore in a report and the different options that may be available to you. I know it's a lot of information to consume, but my biggest thing is play around with the report, just explore Power BI to get the feel for it and to just give it a chance. Let me know in the comments below if there's some aspect of a Power BI report that maybe you didn't know about that I showed or that you really love and maybe I didn't call it out. Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.